Right now, I'm stay two, and I'm really high, really horny, really out of it, and I'm at a sex club in the East Village. It's just filled with old men, and I really don't want to have sex with them, but if I'm horny enough, I'll end up having sex with them. I'm gonna suck a lot of dick. Since I can't suck yours.
I remember the days when the bathhouses used to be fun and they weren't filled with people whacked out on crystal.
Go do your crystal and, you know, room to room to room, party, party, party.
I do not want to hear each week how many more of you are becoming health. HIV infections are up as much as 40%. You cannot continue to allow yourselves and each other to act and live like this.
I don't make it a habit like these other faggots that do it every day. I don't party every day.
This drug comes along which lowers your emissions. The people are just waiting for it. They're just like, yeah, let's go, fuck, fuck, fuck.
Meth is a hypersexual drug. It increases libido. It decreases disinhibition. In some ways, people have labeled this as the most ideal drug for gay men. Who are these people who are becoming addicted to this drug? What are their characteristics? Well, they're not necessarily white or black or 35 or 22 or HIV positive or HIV negative. What seems to be consistent about these men is that these are men who have a difficult time in social situations. They have a difficult time relating to other people, and so the drug makes them feel disinhibited. In some ways, people have labeled this as the most ideal drug for gay men. Gay men, because their identity is built around their sexuality in part. Gay men, also because gay men as a group experience issues of loneliness and depression at higher levels than the general population, which then attracts them to this drug, which masks those feelings.
People just don't wake up one morning and say, I'm going to be a meth user, or I'm going to be a bareback, or whatever that means. They don't just wake up and decide they're going to take risks. But they live their lives and go through these developmental paths that bring them to a point that they feel that they need to use these drugs.